Cardinals nor Bruce Willis won an
Philadelphia, where the name Tommy Conwell has been familiar for about 5 years. Conwell's first album, recorded on original basis, sold about 70,000 copies locally and brought him to the attention of Columbia Records. Sandy Canyon reports on his national debut.
Need a fresh face on the national music scene who's no stranger to rock audiences in his hometown of Philadelphia. Though I've been here a while, don't think that I
stopped moving. I'm on my way. We took our time, but we took our time because we wanted to get it right.
Tommy Conwell is talking about his first album for a major record label. I'm not your man, but you're looking for a hero. That cut was just another song to the guitarist until it was released as a single.
Sometimes when you record something and it gets some airplay on the radio, it takes on a life of its own. You know, a song that might just be another song might have this secret life that you haven't seen yet, where it just sounds really good on the radio. And that's what I'm Not Your Man had.
What's become reality for Conwell and his Rumblers was merely a dream back in 1984 when they first got together.
It was terrible.
Well, my first job with Tommy, we didn't even practice. We got together with just me and Tommy. He said, hey, you know,
this one's an E, this one's an A.
Yeah, that's how we did it. We just played the song.
One of the songs became a regional hit. Well, let's go walking. Walking on the water. Next, the band started opening concerts for more established acts. And therein lies a tale.
You know, I was meeting these people, I might as well get their autograph. And one day I didn't have a piece of paper, so I got it on my guitar.
A tradition was established, hence all those famous signatures on his instrument. John Lee Hooker and Chrissy Hynde from The Pretenders, to mention just a few. Today, Conwell isn't so much getting autographs as giving them out himself. Many in the record industry are predicting stardom for this group, and that's put heat on its members to really cook.
It's a lot of work, and the pressure on top of it compounds it, but in general, we try to go about our business as we always have, not change a thing, and that tends to alleviate that pressure.
We worked real hard when we were in Philadelphia, and that's what we're doing out here, too.
And their proof, hard work does pay off.
Wherever you are, you can make it. You know, whatever town you're in, you could be the next Bryan Adams or the next Rolling Stones from Des Moines, Iowa, or wherever, you know. It doesn't have to be a major city. Just practice real hard.
Clearly, the young Rumblers and their leader, Tommy Conwell, have followed their own advice. Sandy Kenyon, CNN Entertainment News, Hollywood.
Still to come on Showbiz.